Welcome to King Said So, Africa's one land, one language, one currency, one army on King Said So. Africans can unite, your Pan-Africanist podcast. Enjoy.
Peace in Pan-Africanism to all my African brothers and sisters from all around the world. Welcome back to King Said So, the morning drive. And we're back at it again with another one. And look, it's very interesting. Well, before I start there, I hope you guys have seen the video I've made for you guys about, what is it again? Cape Independence nonsense. And I said in that video, it is so difficult to go up against this rubbish that the, what is his name, Phil Crate is doing. Because there's colored people and black people that are joining him in this nonsense. And there's other white people in the Cape that don't understand what the hell is going on here. But we always, I almost want to call ourselves sellouts. We always sell out to white people's visions, us as colored and black people, as if we don't have a vision for ourselves. It's very hurting. So check that video out. I spoke in length on that topic. I might need to do a part two where I clearly state the numbers of that small party that is trying to do this. So Thabo Mbheki, who was so vocal last year, just last year before Zuma announced that he will be backing Nkonto with Sizwe, Thabo Mbheki was the guy that was, you know, saying, listen, you can't vote for the ANC. The ANC is corrupt. The leaders are corrupt. I'll never vouch to say vote for the ANC. He was the first person to say that before Zuma did anything. Now you find out a situation where he started campaigning for the ANC. But Thabo Mbeki's campaign for the ANC was not a genuine one. It was never a genuine one. Because for him, it was all about getting back to Jacob Zuma. You know, Thabo Mbeki will take any opportunity just to come and smear mud on Jacob Zuma's name. That's what he was basically doing, Mbeki. So we know what type of a character he is. He was there just to tell people how good his term was in office and how bad everyone's term was, and only him and Mandela managed to put South Africa in an upward trajectory. So that's it. Now, surprisingly, now the ANC has to go to the Eastern Cape, which I believe is his birth country. He does not want to go there, you know, because he understands the type of level, the standard our people are living in the Eastern Cape. So he can't bring himself to go and try and, you know, campaign in the Eastern Cape for the ANC. It's difficult for Thabo Mbeki. So it's very nice to see how this whole thing is going to unfold in that regard. Three ballot papers. I am agreeing with this notion that is flying around that you or I might need to split our vote in the three ballot papers. Remember, the national ballot paper, you are voting for the guys that are going to go to parliament. You understand? The regional paper is the one where you're voting for your region to represent you in parliament. And then the provincial one, it's only for people who are for parties that are vying for a position of getting a mini parliament in the province. So yes, it's true. We might just need to split that vote and make sure that we are all aware of what is going on in that regard. You know, because provincial, our politics are different province to province. So you might need to vote for a particular party in your province that it's not necessarily the party that you would vote for in the national setup. It's very important to remember that, and I agree with that point of view that yeah, there's other people that are just going to split their vote. Other people might just say EFF, Pumelapo, MK, or Pumelapo. That's also fine. But look at the quality of your party. If they do have the strength to lead you provincially, make sure that you guys just make sure that you educate yourself. You're listening to political debates. You're listening to YouTube channels. You're making sure that you don't get one narrative like the mainstream media is trying to push. Make sure that you are all awake when it comes to this provincial and national governments. Make sure that you're doing your thing very well, guys. Make sure that you're doing your thing very well. So for me, that's very important. That's so important. I like that. I like this thing of splitting the vote. I agree with it, in fact. So, yes, I'm already at work. I'm not actually working this side today. I'm working the other side. I'm just here to help someone with their car. But thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. Don't forget to tune to watch African Mujolo. African Mujolo is very... Oh, this guy, is he already leaving? What's going on? African Mujolo with King. Make sure that you watch him, and you're gonna enjoy the content in that channel. I promise you. As I drive out, because I see now, he's already leaving. This guy, what is going on? No, other people's heads don't work properly. Other people's heads. You know when you help someone who does not want to help themselves. Let me just pause quickly here. So yes, I'm one of those friends that carry an electric pump, cable, jumping cables, and all of those things in my car. That my car that does not need those things. But because I used to drive a scrap, but a car that gave me a lot of problems, my Ford Fiesta, before I bought this car, I was struggling. Every day it was jumping cable. Every day it was this and that. I became a mechanic driving that car. I knew that car's engine in and out. In fact, I bought a new secondhand engine for that car. And then it was in December and my mechanic did not have anyone to assist him. And I helped put the engine with him, so I know how to balance an engine and make sure that everything is in place. Because of that car, it gave me so much knowledge. Now, because I've got jumping cables and all of those things, and people don't listen when you tell them things, now I'm assisting someone taking his car to the mechanic, my mechanic actually, because his mechanic has been messing his car up. So yes, ladies and gentlemen, I'm quite interested on the political strategy that these political parties are going to push in the next 2 weeks. Are they able to think out of the box? What is it that they can do? We call it the last minute kick of a dying horse. What is it that political parties can do to convince us even more to say that they are the right parties? Because I believe many people think they know what they're going to vote for, but every time something comes up, it changes people's minds, you know. The own goal, these political parties that are not stopping in scoring own goals and stuff like that. So, I wish someone can make me ahead of campaigning. There's so many things that, great ideas that I think can do. Especially to win a region, a kasi, like political parties, for me, it's like they don't think outside the box like they should. But anyway, that's my point of view. Today being a Wednesday, we are so much work to push. So much work to push. David orders going off. Oh, because yeah. Sebenzela mahala. Sebenzela mahala. I'm telling you. It's like training mahala njenge Kaizer Chiefs. Sa trainer mara. Awubona ukuthi train land. Yeah, guys. Start a business, guys. I promise you. Even if you are working, start a business, guys. Do not allow yourself to be salary dependent. Yo, that's the worst thing on earth. That is the most worst thing on earth that a man can do, being dependent on one salary. Yo, oh, the struggles that we are having. Guys, I can't. Okay, guys, so thank you so much for tuning in. Let me assist this brother. We are already in the making. Kimberly is small, guys. Kimberly is small. How can I explain how small the town of Kimberly is? What examples can I make that are outside the Northern Cape? If you know Bronkhorstspruit in Gauteng North, if you know Bronkhorstspruit, how the size of the town, not the entire town with the resident, the town alone. Bronkhorstspruit is bigger than Kimberley. If you know Bronkhorstspruit, it's bigger than Kimberley. So I think that should give you an idea just how big Kimberley is or is not. So moving from one place to another here, literally with my car, 250 rand, or let me say 300 rand now, the petrol is going up and stuff. It's enough for the whole entire week. And that includes church and gym, not only work, church and gym and going to work. 300 rand is enough for me weekly. I don't drive much up and down and stuff like that. So it's nice. That's why I got so many job offers to go and stay in Pretoria. I'll never go and stay in Pretoria or Joburg, never. To drive 60 kilometers a day. Yeah, I stay 1.8 kilometers from my work. Why would I want to pack up and leave and go and drive 60 kilometers every day? No, no, thank you. I'm fine here in Kimberley. Perfect here in Kimberley. I'll see you guys on the flip side. Thank you so much for tuning in on the morning drive. I love you guys so much. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for the support. Until we meet next time, don't forget to pray. After you pray, stand up, African child. Do your best so that God can do the rest. Peace. Pan-Africanism, I salute you.